someone dies, where do they go? Is there a heaven? Is there a hell? This is the age-old debate. No matter what you believe, today we will be looking at stories from people who have seen or have been to hell. And let me tell you, it's worse than you could ever imagine. Starting off this countdown, we have Jennifer Perez. This is a pretty famous case of a young Christian girl who was sent to hell and then back. So Jennifer was raised in a very Christian household. As she grew older, she found herself falling out of her faith, and she started doing drugs. In fact, in the early 2000s, she actually overdosed, died, and then was sent to hell. This is how she described it. Apparently, she was first sent to heaven. She found herself standing ashamed in front of God. He then told her that she failed to show the fruit of her faith, and she was sent to hell. She remembers falling while feeling her surroundings become hotter and hotter. Then, an intense smell of sulfur filled her lungs. She heard screams of agony and saw people being tortured. Fortunately, though, Jennifer was brought back to life and given a second chance. Now, she wants to correct her wrongdoing, so when she does pass again, she will spend her life in heaven. Moving on to number 9, we have The Apocalypse of Peter. Around the late 2nd century, the book The Apocalypse of Peter appeared, and it described a terrifying vision one had of hell. According to the narrator, sinners are hung by their tongues over bubbling pools of gore. Blasphemers are tortured by getting red-hot iron stabbed into their eyes. Also, clouds of worms trail over the landscape, devouring everything in their path. And extreme sinners are thrown off of cliffs or get their eyes burnt out. Well then, that got extremely dark extremely fast. Moving on to number 8, we have Bill Weiss. In November of 1998, a devout Christian man, Bill Weiss, was sent down to hell for 23 minutes. He later detailed his experience in his book, 23 Minutes in Hell. On that day, he found himself falling down a long tunnel before finding himself in a dark, dirty prison. The prison was extremely hot. In fact, he thought he was going to die from how hot it was. Not only that, but two large creatures were sharing the cell with him. Bill also talked about the constant screaming, foul odors, raging pits of fire, torment, and intense darkness. After the 23 minutes, he saw a bright light and was lifted out of the tunnel and back to Earth. He now wants to share his experience with the world. Moving on to number 7, we have Saint Faustina's visions. Mary Faustina was a Polish nun during the early 20th century who apparently had a number of visions about hell. According to her, and I quote, "Hell is a gigantic, smoky chamber filled with a suffocating, indescribable stench in each eternal darkness. Demons tiptoe from pit to pit, unleashing special tortures tailor-made for each new soul, while God himself burns sinners with his own agonizing fire." She continued on, saying that the majority of souls in hell are non-believers. Those who sinned actually end up in purgatory instead, I guess for a chance to fix your ways before then going to heaven. Moving on to number 6, we have the vision of Anne Catherine Emmerich. Anne Catherine was an 18th century mystic. Sadly, she was constantly tortured with horrifying visions. The worst was the vision she received of hell. According to Anne, hell is a dirty, rundown city. Buildings are collapsed, there's tons of swamps where sinners are, and vipers and reptiles slither between buildings, attacking and eating lost souls. On top of all that, demons wander around and Lucifer is chained up, constantly howling in agony. Not only that, she said that she saw a number of prophecies on the walls of hell, which said that Satan was going to be released onto Earth before the year 2000. So could it be that he's currently wandering around Earth, taking souls back with him to hell? Maybe. We are now at our 5th and halfway mark with Sister Josefa Menendez. Sister Josefa Menendez was a Spanish nun in the early 20th century. Sadly, she was only a nun for 4 years before passing away in the convent at 33. Now, while living there, she received a number of terrifying visions of hell. This scared her immensely because she was a loyal follower of God. She was so nervous that she didn't want to write down the description of hell that she saw. Alas, she managed to do so. According to her, hell is filled with long, dark corridors and internally burning fires. Not only that, but any soul condemned to hell loses the power to feel love or happiness or any positive emotions. All they feel is cruelty and misery. In a heartbreaking passage, she wrote about a soul that said they would give anything just to be able to feel love again. That is so freaking sad. So it's not even like you forget what all the happy feelings feel like. No, you remember it and you long for it daily. In our 4th spot, we have the vision of Tundale. During the Middle Ages, an Irish man by the name Tundale had a 2-day trip to hell. According to him, in hell, people are cooked to be made into a soup. There are gigantic frying pans in which people are cooked in. Not only that, but demons with their little pitchforks push people off of mountains. Others chop people up into little bits and then magically put them back together again, only to chop them up again. And this is a perpetual cycle, so it's endless torture. And apparently, Tundale himself was tortured while down there. The most terrifying thing that he reported was Acheron. Acheron is a gigantic beast that can swallow 9,000 men at a time. Once you're inside of his body, you're then eaten by other things that are inside of his body, like snakes and rats, all while being burned and suffocated with sulfur. How pleasant does that sound? Coming in at number 3, we have the curse. Have you ever told someone, go to hell? Well, if you have, then you just cursed yourself. According to a number of religious texts, if you curse someone, you are actually cursing yourself in return. Here's a text. If you are even angry with someone, you're subject to judgment. If you call someone an idiot, you're in danger of being brought before the court. And if you curse someone, you are in danger of the fires of hell. Matthew 5:22. So the curse is like a boomerang. In the end, you'll be in hell and suffering more than the person that you tried to curse. Moral of the story, don't curse people. Coming in at number 2, we have Groundhog Day. According to Matthew 25:46, those who have decided to reject God and his commandments will go away into eternal punishment, while the righteous will be led into eternal life. In hell, you will be constantly tortured and tormented. According to some religious texts, in hell, you will be chained and forced to relive your bad choices on earth day after day. You'll be constantly surrounded by your sins, reliving their moments over and over again. Not only that, others will be able to see your sins as well. Literally, this will drive you to insanity, and no matter what you do, you can't escape it, so it's eternal. And in our number 1 spot today, we have Emanuel Swedenborg. In the mid-18th century, scientist and philosopher Emanuel Swedenborg claimed that there was more than one heaven and more than one hell. He said that there were 3 versions of heaven, all pretty much the same versions of themselves, whereas the hells were insanely different. In one hell, the sinners are trapped in a big, decaying city filled with violence. Demons and lost souls live together, but they spend their days fighting each other. In another hell, it's a burning city with every building being a brothel, where people are forced to engage in certain activities with each other, and not just like normal stuff, no, like things involving excrement, if you get what I'm saying. Another hell is a dark forest filled with beasts and endless deserts and dark, dirty caves. So, which hell would you rather spend the rest of your life in? Let me know in the comments below. Alright guys, and speaking of comments, let's move on to our comment shoutout portion. I'll be shouting out comments from the video Top 10 Secret Disasters Worse Than Chernobyl. Cyril Rodriguez commented, hi Lindsay. Well, hi, how are you? Hope you're doing well. Thanks. James Little commented, Merry Christmas and I like the hat, but why? James, why not? How about that? Why not? Okay, don't be a hater. I love cows. Velvet cow cowboy hat? Sure, I'll wear it. Also, a fan sent it to me, so I wanted to wear it in a video for him, so. And Victor Voigt commented, did you get that hat from a Dalmatian? You know, those cute little black and white dogs? First off, I'm really glad that you explained what a Dalmatian was, because I was like, Dalmatian, what is that? Oh, it's a black and white dog. Duh. No, it's a cow hat. Cows are my favorite animals. It's a cow, not a Dalmatian. Nice try though. All right guys, that's all the comments I'm shouting out for today's video. Make sure to comment something down below for a chance to be featured in my next comment shout out. And as always, don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up and subscribe to Most Amazing Top 10 for more amazing videos. I've been your host, Lindsay Ivan, and I'll see ya when I see ya. Bye.